要
上
是
上失去我们的这希望。而今天我们要学习的是以西结圣殿耶和华沙玛。
The 25 places that God showed Ezekiel in the Ezekiel's temple. So today we're going to go on from there to the next point, which is.Notable features in visit to Ezekiel's temple. The notable features in visiting the temple. What are some special unique characteristics and traits of this temple? First,
the very first place to visit was the wall
on the outside of the temple all around. So first thing they Ezekiel saw was the Ezekiel chapter 40 verse 5.And behold, there was a wall on the outside of the temple all around, and in the man's hand was a measuring rod of 6 cubits, each of which was a cubit and a handbreadth. So he measured the thickness of the wall, 1 rod, and the height, 1 rod.
So here's the measurements
that are used in the book of Ezekiel. I say in the book of Ezekiel because it is a little bit different from the rest of the Bible. So here's the length measurements and units. We'll quickly go over this because I'm going to repeat the content again.
First, cubit
here is 6 handbreadths.And in Hebrew,
有六个
cubit is like a standard measurement. And those of you who speak Chinese, you know that Alma, what Alma says is already always the standard, right? Anyway,
他说一走在希伯来文是 Alma.
Structures such as Noah's Ark, the tabernacle, and Zerubbabel's temple, most of the important measurements are in cubits.
所罗门的圣殿、以西结的圣殿，这些地方都是运用了走来测量的。
One cubit plus a hand breadth. One cubit plus a hand breadth. Here, Ezekiel chapter 40, verse 5, it says,
第四十章第五节说。
He had a measuring rod of 6 cubits, right? And each of these cubits was a cubit, normal cubit, plus a handbreadth, okay? So here, a long cubit is the cubit in Ezekiel, but the book doesn't specify...By saying long cubit, it doesn't say long cubit.
那在以西结书里面的不同是呢，它的轴呢是长轴，可是虽然它没有这样子写啊，它有解释过一次，一轴是一轴加上多一个掌。
One cubit is from the.
所以以西结书四十章第五节说，我见殿四围有墙，那人手拿两度的杆，长六肘，每肘是一肘零一掌，所以一肘加上一掌，这就是长肘。他用杆量墙，厚一杆，高一杆，杆是六肘。
And so together it's 53.2.
所以总共呢，这个长轴是53.2公分。普通的一轴是45.6公分。这也被称为长轴或royal 是王那个王的用的这个轴，则是在以西结书里面的这个轴是。
One finger, therefore, is 1/24 cubit, okay, as we see in Jeremiah 52, verse 21. And then it says that he had a rod.
所以这里说到了他拿的这个杆，对吗？
6 long cubits. This is one long cubit, right? 53.2 centimeters.Was Ezekiel's cubit?
这表示呢，六肘长六个长肘是3.19公尺。
Six long cubits was one rod or one reed, which is 3.19 meters. Okay, which is 319 centimeters. Okay, 3.19 meters. Okay, and another tool, measuring tool he had was a line of flax, which is measuring for measuring even longer measurement. Okay, so a man whose appearance was like the appearance.
而在那个时候呢，出现了一个人，他呢的样子像是铜做的。
We are going to talk about why these measurements later in weeks to come.
以后我们会更加仔细的。
The different length in the cubit. It's called the cubit.
以后我们会更加仔细的来解释这些东西的尺寸。
And we'll talk about that later. But one thing is the standard.
那你要知道，以西结书里面的轴跟圣经其他地方的轴是不同的。以西结的长轴是多了零一丈。这是因为呢，这是代表着天国的，代表着天国的尺寸。
And so heavenly standards are different from.
也可以说
，Noah's Ark, Solomon's Temple, Tabernacle—they are built and they are meant to be built on earth by humans.
也可以说，这个是一个不同的标准，是属天国的标准。
And so our actions and things that we do are different in different standards as heaven. And therefore,
这等于说，今天我们必须要问自己：我属天国。
Citizen of,
还是属世界呢？
Do I belong
to
heaven, 我
到底是属于哪里呢？
That will decide, and we will have to decide and make a determination in our hearts. Which standards am I going to live by?
这代表我们必须问自己，我们要照着什么样的标准生活？要照着天国的标准，还是要照着世界的标准呢？让我们好好的问自己。那现在我们要回顾一下，刚才我们说到了这一个杆用来测量的杆呢是长六肘，而一肘是一肘零一丈，而普通一肘是45.6公分，可是加上的零一丈呢，长肘就是53.2公分，是45.6加上7.6公分，这是刚才我们所说的。现在我只是再回顾一番，而整条杆是六肘，六肘是3.19公尺，所以城墙是3.19公尺厚高，3.19公尺高，他把它。牧师把它就是圆起来，圆成3.2公尺，所以我们可以看，这是一个非常稳固的，因为是又这么高又这么厚的城墙。
The height is 3.2.
很稳固，对吗
？And the thickness also 3.2 meters. How long is 3.2 meters? How tall are you?
3.2公尺有多长多大？
你
如果你拿你自己的
，it might be about 3 times.
如果你拿自己的高度来测量，就是差不多两倍，对吗
？Normally about twice your height.
测量差不多两倍。
A wall of that thickness.
他说：“你可以想象吗？一个城墙这么高，这么厚，这么厚的城墙是容易给人家容易给人家打进去的吗？”而这个城墙是受到了神的。圣洁的保护，好让邪恶不能够侵入，不能够进入。所以今天希望天父在我们的生命中建立起这个城墙，
the sinfulness, the temptations will not be able to penetrate through that wall.
让我们不会
so the wall protects God's holiness.
希望神在我们的生命中建立这个城墙，让黑暗和邪恶不会攻入。
In order to live in that spiritual
temple,
what's the first thing we need?
We need
something that's a barrier between profane and holiness. And we need to decide which side are we going to live in.
那我们必须要
There has to be a clear distinction. If the
wall is that thick,
there is a clear border and distinction between the profane and the holy. Right? And therefore,We need to decide, we need to have, our life needs to have a clear border between good and evil.
要有一个非常明确
的of eating from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil
区别就是我们的生命以及外面别人的生命要有非常明显的区别。
Sometimes we think
所以我们不可以
we like it,
说
we think No harm to it, but it's. It
我们不可以说哦，外面其他的人这么做，我们也要跟着这么做，因为这是不正确，对吗？
And something that we just did not want to do, but it's something that God wants to see us do. So what God wants is good, and what God does not like is bad, and there has to be a clear.Wow.
神要我们做的是好的，神不希望我们做的是不好，所以我希望我们能够有这个非常明显的区别。神也会给我们能力来选好。
The bank of the river. The first place to visit was the wall, that separated the good and the evil, the holy and the profane.The last place he visited was the bank of the river.
以西结所去的最后一个地方就是那条河旁。这是记载在以西结书四十六章第七节。
The river is
以西结书四六第七节说，他也要预备。
Chapter 47 verse 9 it says.It will come
about that every living creature
which swarms in every place where the river goes will live. And
there will be very many fish.
For these waters go there and go, and the others become fresh, and everything will live where the river goes. So this is the river of life that gives life even to what was dead.So it's talking about the Dead Sea, and everything that it touches will come back to life and will receive life. Something probably the most special about Ezekiel's temple is this river of life.
以西结书里面呢，我们可以读到有关这个生命河，而生命河是非常神奇的。那个河水不懂流到哪里，不管流到哪里。都会，所有一切的东西都会活起来。
Emblematic landscapes or parts of the kingdom of heaven. So this river of life is something that needs to be restored in us, in our church, in our family.
这个生命河呢，必须在我们的生命中，在我们的家庭中，复活起来。
By the river on its bank, on one side and on the other, will grow all kinds of trees for food.Their leaves will not wither, and their fruit will not fail.
以西结书的四十七章十二节说，在这河边和那边的岸上必生长各类的树木，其果可作食物，叶子不枯干，果子不断绝，每月必结新果子，因为这水是从圣所流出来。树上的果子必作食物，叶子仍为治病。所以你可以想象吗？这个水是多么的神奇！如果你有病，你不用吃药；如果你有头痛，你不用吃Panadol，你直接就是喝这个，喝这个河流出来的水，你就可以马上痊愈了。他说：“可能你会觉得说，有可能吗？ 这好像是我们必须进天国才会发生的事。
If we can find the spiritual river, and you can imagine if you have been studying the word, what is that river that gives life?
那如果你有在学习神的道，可能你就已经明白到这一个能够给你生命的河水是什么，就是耶稣基督的宝血。耶稣基督的宝血。那如果你是种植在这个河水旁边，你而你喝这个水，你吃喝耶稣给你的这个血，耶稣给你的这个河水的话呢，你就能够成为常常为神结果子的这个树了。
And the leaves,
而你知道吗？这棵树果子不断绝，叶子不枯干，叶子也能够治病。
You know, the fig tree that Jesus came to was looking for that fruit, only had leaves, right? And what do those leaves represent in that?
耶稣他去到以色列的时候，他看到那棵树，那棵树只有叶子。
Full of words and talk,
而叶子代表什么呢？叶子代表那些喜欢自夸的人。
A lot of leaves, you know, it looks flush, it looks plenty, it looks.
所以外表看起来呢，其实好像是很好，可是其实在他们的里头没有任何的果子。
Our leaves, if we become the tree planted by the river of life.And our leaves produce,
那如果我们种植在生命河的旁边，
和
我们，就是那棵树种植在生命河的旁边，那这表示我们可以结果子来喂饱身边的人，我们也可以有这个叶子来为别人治病。那是多么的好。我们可以帮助身边的一切人，所以我希望我们能够成为这样的一棵树，我们能够有果子，人家作为食物，我们能够有叶子来为人家治病等等。
And for their not for their healing and for their growth and for their satisfaction.When he showed me, and this is Revelation 22, verse 1
when he showed me a river of the water of life,
clear as crystal. See, in Ezekiel, we see the crystal plate, right?
天使又指示我在城内街道当中一道生命水的河。明亮如水晶，从神和羔羊的宝座流出来。在这边，在河的这边和那边有生命树，结十二样果子，每月都结果子。树上的叶子能认为医治万民。所以耶稣给了我们这个生命树上的水。约翰第四章十三十四节。
Speaking about the water from the well, right? But whoever drinks
耶稣回答说，凡喝这水的还要再渴。人若喝我所赐的水，就永远不渴。我所赐的水要在他里头成为泉源，直涌到永生。所以希望我们也可以给耶稣喝耶稣所赐的这个水。约翰第七章37-38节，节期末日就是最大之日。耶稣站着高声说：“人若渴了，可以到我这里来喝。信我的人，就如经上所说，从他腹中要流出活水的江河来。”
Or the throne of God.
所以这个活水是从哪里开始流出来？是从神的圣所。
The living water began from the sanctuary. I pray that the living water.
所以我希望这个活水也可以从我们西安的圣所流出来。
I believe that there's pastors and leaders watching from these different countries and different places.
现在。
The sanctuary of your church.
我们有许多的人加入来听我们的课，所以呢，
Then he brought me back to the door of the house, and behold, water was flowing from
under
the threshold of the house
toward
the east, the house
facing, and the water was flowing down from under, from the right side of the house, and from the south of the house. Let me, 这水从龛下由殿的右边，在祭坛的南边往下流。
This whole square, this
所以如果你看以西结圣殿的这个图，你可以从图中看到水是从圣所流出来。
This is the river of life flowing down here, and if I
水是从圣所一直流出来，就是那个蓝色。
From under the threshold, this is a threshold right here. From under the threshold,
跟着红色的那一点，从蓝色那条就是生命河了。
So, just like in Revelation, river was flowing from the throne of God. Here in Ezekiel's temple, the river is flowing from the holy place, from the sanctuary, the nave. Yeah,
所以这里清楚地说，圣所。
Ezekiel 47 verse 12, by the river on its bank.
还有呢，以西结书四十七章的十二节说。
And so on. We read this before.
在河这一边和那一边的岸上必生长各类的树木，其果可做食物，叶子不枯干，果子不绝断，每月必结新果子，因为这水是从圣所流出来，树上的果子必做食物，叶子仍为治病。而圣所在希伯来文是 Mizbeah。代表着
the altar for burnt offering
represents
the cross of Jesus. Okay, so can you think of the cross? Okay, under the cross, this river is flowing.
是祭坛的意思。
Okay.Hence the blood
而这个祭坛呢，最终就是代表着我们主耶稣基督的十字架。而我们知道耶稣基督十字架，他的宝血以及沾满了他宝血的福音，这个道呢，就像是这个活水的河一样流出来，能够使像死海一样的世界复活。
But even that dead sea, the dead of all, will come back to life if this river touches. Let us believe that the blood of Jesus Christ and the word that flows from the cross of Jesus Christ will give life to the dead bodies, dead hearts.
所以，让我们来
the deadness of our
祈求耶稣基督的宝血能够使我们死亡的生命、信心等等一切都恢复，都能够恢复。
As you pray for your family, as you pray for yourself, believing that this river of life will give life.
今天你为自己祷告。
The answers to that prayer and the power of the prayer and the blood of Jesus Christ. Although I cannot see you, can you say amen to that?
今天如果你在为自己祷告，在为
So the uniqueness of Ezekiel's temple is that the altar for
在为自己祷告，在为所有的人祷告的话呢，
okay,
你要相信。
Another uniqueness is that Ezekiel's temple is in the square shape. Okay? Square shape. The tabernacle is not square. Okay? The Solomon's temple is not square. The only square part that you can remember is the Holy of Holies, the most holy place.
城墙是四方的，就是以西结的圣所。
The New Jerusalem is square. All four sides are the same. Meaning, representing God's justice.
那新耶路撒冷的四边都是一样的，这代表着神的正义，因为神是正义，所以四方正方正方形。
And in the center of this,
而现在我们看以西结的圣殿呢，也是正方形。
Right in the center,
而在这个正方形的中心就是祭坛。刚才我们说到祭坛。祭坛就代表耶稣的十字架，对吗？他说我不懂，你会不会记得
？The tabernacle was in this shape, right?
刚才我们有
Okay. And the altar for burnt offering was about here. It was not the center. But in Ezekiel's temple, the altar for burnt offering is right in the center.
啊，所以呢，如果我们看以前的这个圣所，圣所的这个祭坛是在门呢，接近门那边。可是呢，当我们看以西结的圣殿，它的祭坛是在中间，表示我们的生命呢必须有耶稣基督的十字架为中心。
So if we hold on to that cross.
我们要有耶稣十字架，我们必须保守耶稣给我们的教导。那如果我们可以这么做，我们也可以进入神的天国的中心。
那
这个活水呢，也与恢复伊甸园有关系。为什么呢？因为当这个水从圣所流出来，也提醒了我们，神使水从伊甸园流出来。在伊甸园里面有一条河，然后流出来之后呢，就分为四条河。四条河代表。
The number four represents the
四代表着东南西北，也代表着全世界。
covers the whole world. So it's the word that comes out from the center of the paradise and spreads out into four directions to cover the world.
是从神的天国流出来到世界各地。
There is a river whose streams make glad the city of God, the holy dwelling places of the Most High.John chapter 19, verse 23. Then the soldiers, when they had crucified Jesus, took his outer garments and made four parts, a part to every soldier, and also the tunic. Now the tunic was seamless, woven in one piece. See, you can see different subjects or different places in the Bible where four becomes one and one becomes four.Or something like four in one or one in four. And one of that is we can see in the Garden of Eden, the water, the river comes out, one river becomes four. Right? And then Jesus' garments, okay, there's one and four.
而他所穿的内衣只有一件。
Four living beings, it's one, it speaks as though it's one being and four faces.Four beings in one.
当我们看到了这个基路伯，基路伯也是有四个面。那还有呢？神的话语呢，也被写在四个福音中。
In four different ways, four gospels, and the four gospels are called the gospel, the word of God that needs to be proclaimed to the world, right?And so, just like Jesus' word was divided into seven on the cross, it's the word that is one, becoming four to cover the world.
而这个福音必须要笼罩全世界。
The true temple,
耶稣十字架的活福音从耶稣开始，而这是从伯利恒。 流出来，到耶路撒冷、撒玛利亚，而最终会抵达到世界各处的每一个地方，来完成救赎时这一条河。
Again, flow started to flow from the cross, and I believe it is still flowing. Let me challenge yourself to ask you.
所以呢，我要问你，今天这条河在你的生命中是已经枯干掉了，还是是有很多水在流着，在给你生命吗？
Just so dry and cannot find. Micah chapter 5 verse 2.
米迦书第五章第二节说到伯利恒，使徒行传第一章第八节说，通过圣灵，我们成为耶稣的见证人。
39,
所以耶稣给我们的水，耶稣说从我们腹中会流出来的泉源，这个水就是圣灵了。得圣灵的人会明白耶稣的道，得圣灵的人明白神的道，得神的道的人得神的圣灵。道和圣灵是一起的，不能够分开。有时候有些人他们说不想要听神的道，他们只想要注重这个圣灵，其实是不可能的。你不可以有这种的态度，不可以有这种态度。
It works together. The word of God.
因为神的道跟圣灵是一起的。
So the blood of Jesus Christ, that the river of life that started to flow from the cross.It is carried by the Holy Spirit to us. And if
圣灵
your water is dry,
会把神的道中的生命带给我们。
Through the Word of God. Go where you can receive the Word. And sometimes it's not easy because receiving the Word is like working out.
那这是不简单。
It's something that is, that
为什么呢？因为我们要领受神的道和圣灵，我们必须要工作，我们必须要用力才可以得到。
We have to spend time. We have to really make a determination, push ourselves. Likewise, receiving the word is. But once you get into the flow of it.
那可是呢，如果你是常常领受神的道的人，没有他的道，你其实是不会活的。
The living water of the end time gospel that will also begin from being little and flow to the rest of the world.
所以呢，这个水开始流出来的时候是非常小的非常少，然后慢慢流，越流越多。以西结书的四十七章第二节里面说，他带我出北门，又领我到外边传到朝东的门外，见水从右边流出。所以这里开始说，这个水流出来呢只是非常小的。当你看到这个水，你会觉得这个水不可能变成一条河。而在希伯来文，这个小水，这一小，是帕卡。
Our church might be so small. Our influence.
那我们的教会，可能你会觉得说教会还小间。
Can you imagine? When Jesus,
那耶稣在十字架上的时候呢，在耶稣基督十字架的脚，那十字架下有几个人呢？才几个人呢？对吗？所以我们可以说，如果我们要说耶稣是一个，耶稣是一个牧师，其实他并不是一个非常成功的。
And then at the end.
那开始的时候，耶稣可能有人跟他，可是后来呢，却有许多人逃走。
Only five remained. I don't know. I think
一个十字架下呢，只有剩了五个人。
Pretty bad.
五个人很少，对吗
？And you can you imagine from that five, it'll become. I mean, later, even after Jesus died and resurrected,
你可以想象在五个人。
Of course, there were. They say there were about 500 people. See that witnessed Jesus.
从五个人后来有多少人看到耶稣升天？
Can you imagine?
我们知道之后呢，有十二个门徒变成了传福音的这个中心。
They thought it was possible or realistic. We say.We need to proclaim this word to the ends of this earth.
他们是传福音的核心团队。那可能今天你会说，我们的教会这么小，我们其实没有什么会员，是不是说很多人也没有很多的这个能力？可是你要记得，当时他们只有十二个人。启示录第十章十至十一节，神的道创造了整个宇宙，而这个道被称为的小书卷，在世界上这个小书卷看起来非常不重要，可是这个小书卷拥有了创造整个宇宙的力量。启示录十四章第六第七节，
having an eternal gospel to preach to those who live on the earth and to every nation and tribe and tongue and people.
启示录十四章第六第七节
，Fear God and give Him glory, because the hour of His judgment has come.
这里说，我又看见另有有永远的福音要传给住在地上的人，就是各国各族各邦各民。他大声说，应当敬畏神，将荣耀归给他，因他施行审判的时候已经到了。应当敬拜那创造天地海和众水泉源的。所以今天我希望我们能够有这种的态度，虽然我们很小，虽然我们算小，虽然我们是很懦弱，可是呢，只要我们的天父，只要我们的天父帮助我们，他就能够运用我们来使整个宇宙都动弹。
The word of the living water must spread to outside of the temple.
活水，这个活水必须流出来，传到了圣堂的外面。
Jesus' great commission, right? Go therefore and make disciples of all the nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.Teaching them to observe all that I commanded you, and lo, I am with you always, even to the end of the age.
那马太二十八章，
这是耶稣给我们的使命。
这是耶稣给我们的使命。马太二十八章十八至二十节说，耶稣近前来对他们说：“天上地下所有的权柄都赐给我了，所以你们要去，使万民做我的门徒，奉父子圣灵的名给他们施洗，或做给他们。凡我所吩咐你们的，都教训他们遵守。我就常与你们同在，直到世界的末了。”还有。马太二十四章十四节
，It is now time for us to go forth. The water needs to go out of the temple. Amazing.
二十四章十四节说，这天国的福音要传遍天下，为万民做见证。然后末期才来到，所以你看呢，这是很神奇的，对吗？我们必须把神话语传遍全世界。而在以西结圣殿有这个墙，非常厚的墙，什么都不可以进来。可是呢，可以通过这个墙的就是这一条河了，这条河以及这个河水，所以这个河水必须流出去。 神的道，耶稣基督的宝血，耶稣基督的话语必须传出去。神等待挪亚建方舟，不管当时是有暴风雨也好。
That was not the time of the judgment. But when Noah finished, he fully
都没关系，因为呢，神没有使这个水降临。神等到挪亚把方舟建好，然后他才使洪水降临。所以今天呢，神也是在等你和我，要我们做完他所命令的，然后才会说啊，现在是时候让我完成了。
Ezekiel chapter 40 verse 4, the man said to me, Son of man, hear with your ears, and give attention to all that I'm going to show you.
那人对我说，人子啊，凡我所指示你的，你都要用眼看，用耳听，并要放在心上。我带你到这里来，特为要指示你，凡你所见的，你都要告诉以色列家。
He said, eat it and prophesy again.
所以在这里你看神
you have to speak it again. Here he shows the temple. He says, I show it to you. You have to see here.
神对以西结怎么说？说我给你指示的，你要用眼看，用耳听，放在心上，然后你要告诉以色列家。所以今天如果我们相信我们学习是神的话语，
There is always a reason.
神说我让你领受神的话语是要让你可以再出去宣传神的话语。
Chapter 43 verses 10 and 11.
还有希结书十三章。
Describe the temple to the house of Israel.
十到十一节说。
So here's one purpose of why God shows that temple.
人子，你要将这殿指示以色列家，使他们因自己的罪孽惭愧，也要他们量殿的尺寸。他们若因自己所行的一切事惭愧，你就将殿的规模、样式、出入之处和一切形状、典章、礼仪、法则指示他们，在他们眼前写上，使他们遵照殿的一切规模、典章去做。所以这里神说，如果他们惭愧，就是说他们忏悔，你就要给他们殿的模样、样式、这个规模、样式和一切的形状、典章、礼仪、法则指示他们。所以这就是神要我们所做的工作了。
All the designs,
当我们惭愧忏悔的之后，神才给我们这个殿的整个设计、整个规模。所以我为大家祷告，希望通过以西结圣殿，我们每个人都能够醒悟到自己应该学习神的道，领受圣灵，还有宣传神的道。希望这个活水能够从我们的心中流出来，希望从在这里有每个代表的教会流出来。
Whoever is watching here, and may we be the church from which sanctuary.
希望我们成为活水流出来的，有活水流出来的河。我们不只是能够给予别人的果子，也有叶子可以做医治。愿神赐福大家，一起祷告，让我们一起祷告。
Ezekiel's temple, the reason why.
那感谢天父给我们这个机会学习有关以西结圣殿，而今天我们更加明白到为什么我们要学习有关以西结圣殿的每个尺寸。所以，请你批准我们，让我们可以照着你的圣殿来的尺寸来测量自己。我们虽然缺乏很多，请你帮助我们成长。 请你通过耶稣的恩惠，帮助我们，好让我们可以，被建立起来。虽然现在我们很小，我们相信，当你通过你的手，来把我们扶持我们，我们什么都，我们可以做许多工作来荣耀你，而你可以通过我们来完成你的旨意。所以天父，今天希望你会运用我们来做你的工。今天我们希望你的名得荣耀。如果有任何东西没有被好好的没有教好，希望你要把这一切把我们的从我们的心中删除。
And truly make it come
true in our life. 请你使你的道在我们的生命中实现。我们感谢你，以耶稣圣名祷告，阿门。